Welcome to my class. My dear student, today I will take class about adulterant in food and uses of different kinds of unwanted colors in food and what are the effects of different kinds of toxic component which may turn different kinds of cancer. Hope you will enjoy this class. After watching this class, if you have any question, write down on comment box at YouTube segment. Thank you.
Hello my dear student, today I am going to describe about use of chemicals in food preservation. This is a very much important topic, not only for creative exam but also in our daily life we should know about this. There are three classes of chemical preservatives commonly used in food: benzoate, such as sodium benzoate, nitrites such as sodium nitrite, sulfites such as sulfur dioxide. If you look at the ingredient labels of different food, you will frequently see this difference between you can say types of chemical used. Another common preservative that you will commonly see on food label is sorbic acid. All of these chemicals either inhibit the activity of bacteria or kill the bacteria. That is why we can say these are food preservative, and using that kinds of food preservative for preservation different kinds of food. Public awarenesses of food preservatives is uneven. Americans have a perceptions that foodborne illnesses happen more often in other countries. This may be true, but the occurrence of illness, hospitalization and deaths are still high. It is estimated by the Center for Disease Control, CDC, that each year there are 76 million illness and hospitalization and around 5,000 death linked to the foodborne illness. The increasing demand for ready-to-eat fresh food products have led to challenges for food distributors regarding the safety and equality of their food. Artificial preservatives meet some of these challenges, but preserving freshness for longer period of time, but these preservatives can cause negative side effects as well. Sodium nitrate is a preservative used in lunch meats, hams, hot dogs, to prevent botulism. It serves the important function of controlling the bacteria that causes botulism. But sodium nitrate can react with protein or during cooking at high heat to form carcinogenic. It has also been linked to cancer in lab animals. So when we will use different kinds of food preservative, we should aware about this because it has great link to cancer. Finally, you can say that I can say that for over 30 years there has been a debate about whether or not preservatives and other food additives can causes hyperactivity. Studies have found that there may be increases in hyperactivity among children who consume artificial coloring and benzoate preservatives and who are already genetically predisposed to hyperactivity. But these studies are not entirely conclusive. Hyperactivity only increased moderately, and it was not determined if the preservatives coloring or a combination of the two were responsible for the increase. Nowadays, we can use different types of method to preserve our food. I think in industry level, most of the company, they try to preserve their food using different kinds of chemicals because it is easy and cost-consuming process. In a home, we can preserve our daily food or necessary food by the process like drying, freezing, fermenting, pickling, curing, and you can also make jam and jelly.
Okay. So another important topics is that adulterant in food and use of colors.
Food is one of the basic needs for every living being and is a very important aspect for life, but nowadays food are affected by different adulterants. Adulteration is a substance which reduce the vital importance of food. Adulterants like methanol yellow, an artificial color, is used to intensify the color of the turmeric powder. Also, adulterants like chalk powder, brick powder, toxic substances are added to gain profit and to lower the cost so as to compete with the market. Such adulterants can lead to anemia, paralysis, brain damage, stomach disorder, and also cancer. Spice may also be contaminated because of condition under which they are cultivated and harvested. Contaminated spices have been reported to cause certain foodborne illness and spoilages. Adulteration in a food is often present in its most crude form, as prohibited substances are either added partially or wholly substituted. Contamination or adulteration in a food is added for various reasons, which includes financial gain, carelessness, and lack in proper hygienic condition of process, storing, transportation, and selling. Therefore, the consumer is either fooled or usually become victims of disease. In backward or developing countries, such kind of adulteration is usually seen. It is essential for the consumer to be aware of common adulterants and their effects on health. Market has high number of food producers, also food in imported in large amount, which permits the producer to mislead and cheat consumer. And there are producers who take advantages of illegal rules and others who commit food adulteration, and to differentiate between the two is extremely troublesome. Adulteration in foods not only decreases our social value but mortality too. The awarenesses of consumers plays important role in preventing food adulteration. Also, unawarenesses and unfair market behavior might endanger consumer health, and misleading can lead to poisoning. Therefore, basic screening test should be known to common people, I think. So finally, we can say that some harmful effects of health risks which are related with coloring in food or uses different kinds of chemicals. From the above, previous discussion, lastly, we can summarize that the adulteration which is been added in the food items can causes tremendous effect on health without our knowledge. Adulteration can be prevented by few altering steps of our society. Hike of price of food items should be checked by government. While purchasing food items, selection of wholesome and non-adulterated food is necessary to make sure that such food do not cause and health problems. Though presence of adulterants cannot be ensured by visual examination as toxic contaminants are present in very low level, but visual examination before purchase can ensure absence of insect, fungus and other foreign materials. The consumer should avoid buying food from places which do not maintain proper hygienic condition. Both local and branded food stores should be inspected by government bodies. The above general consciousness is simple and easy to initiate for our healthy life. If we tend to actively participate in this change, then we can bring about a healthy and non-venturous future for the upcoming generation. So adulterants or poisonous chemical substance, probable sources and remedies. Now finally I am going to describe about probable sources and remedy. First of all, antibiotics used in fish and cattle food stores in animal bodies. Only drug approved by registered physicians should be used. Secondly, heavy metals, inedible components used in fish and cattle food stores in animal bodies. Avoid using inedible components such as waste products of tanneries, coal, soil, feces of animals. Commercial colors, unapproved colors used in industries, used in manufacturing ice cream, blended ice cream, artificial juice, colored drinks, producing sweet, etc. Avoiding using inedible components such as waste products of tannery, coal, soil, feces of animals. Number next, very common chemicals, formalin, mainly used to preserve dead bodies in the morgue, unapproved use for the preservation of fish, fruits and milk, etc. Avoiding use formalin. Insecticides used as pesticides in vegetable production, but it is poisonous effect exists in many cases. Unapproved use of DDT in dry fish. So after expiring of the effects of poisonous chemicals, vegetables should be sold, not to use DDT in dry fish. Chemical substances, excessive and unapproved use of chemical substances or to ripen fruits and tomatoes. Excessive use of sorbet in soft drinks and energy drinks. Allow the fruits to ripe naturally. Discourage the use of carbide. Use of suitable amount of sorbet. Microbes at the time of production and preparation of food. Microbes can get mixed with the food. Be ensured of biosecurity. So that's all about today's lecture. Hope you have understood today's topics. If you have any question regarding your syllabus or on that particular chapter 5, please write down on comment box of YouTube segment. Thank you.